Hi everyone! Nakakalungkot isipin na sa panahon ngayon, nakakaranas tayo ng challenges sa buhay due to the pandemic. Marami din sa ating mga kaibigan, kamag-anak at kasamahan ang nahaharap sa iba't ibang pagsubok kagaya ng cancer, dialysis, stroke, paralysis at marami pang iba. Na hindi lang ang pag-aalaga ang nasusubok, pati din ang emotional at financial capacity ng family. Bukod kasi sa education, binibigyan din natin ng importance ang health, lalo na sa ating bansa. Pero kadalasan hindi tayo nakapag-prepare ng health concern natin kasi ang katuwiran natin palagi ay, bata pa naman ako, hindi ko kailangan yan. But kung hindi ikaw, paano kung ang magulang, kapatid o anak ang nangangailangan ng medical attention needs? Nakahanda ka ba at ang iyong pamilya financially? Alam nyo, marami ng kwento at storya sa buhay na masagana ang kanilang pamumuhay noon. Pero nang may nagkasakit sa pamilya na unexpected, naubos ang lahat ng savings at pati na din ang kanilang mga property dahil sa malaking financial needs. At ayaw natin na mangyari yan sa atin. Kaya if we can do something about it, we need to plan as early as possible to avoid this unexpected situation. So, kayo ba ay single, married, or single parent? Paano nga ba natin mapaghahandaan ng ganitong sitwasyon? Sino ba ang dapat natin maging dependent or benefactor ng health insurance? Life insurance ba or critical illness ba ang pipiliin? Kailan ka ba dapat kumuha ng life insurance or income protection? At ano ba ang coverage ng insurance plan? Kung interesado po kayo sa topic natin, I'm Dr. Rainer Bautista. Please like, share, and subscribe para mas mapalawak natin ang ating kaalaman sa pagmamanage ng ating pera at para mas maging handa sa ating mga financial decision making. So, tuloy na natin ang ating discussion kung ano ba ang life at critical illness insurance. Ang life at critical illness insurance, or sometimes they call it income protection, ay parehas na magbibigay sa inyo at sa inyong pamilya ng peace of mind. Dahil ito ay protection and security, especially if you are the breadwinner or the head of the family. These products can both provide the confidence and peace of mind that you need when something unexpected happen, while protecting against in a very different risk. Let's start answering some questions. Number one, is life insurance the same as the critical illness cover? Well, life insurance and critical illness cover are not the same thing. But before looking at the major differences between the two covers, it's worth noting their similarities. Like, parehas po silang designed to protect against the risk of financial loss kung may mangyari na hindi inaasahan. They are both payout one time tax-free lump sum in the event of a claim. On the other hand, applications are subject to medical underwriting before they can be approved, based on person's age, gender, health, lifestyle, and occupation. While an insured person for critical illness or beneficiaries for life insurance ay may freedom as to use of funds once they are paid out in the event of a claim. Number 2, what are the key differences between life insurance and critical illness insurance? Well, in a nutshell, the key difference between life insurance and critical illness cover involves the event in which each type of insurance would pay out. Life cover would pay out a one-time off tax-free lump sum if you were to die during the term of your policy, while critical illness cover would pay out upon diagnosis of a serious illness, disability, or medical condition as outlined within the policy guidelines. In other words, sa life insurance, ang makikinabang ay ang beneficiary, while the critical illness ay ang insured person. Life insurance is a fairly straightforward. Kung ang policyholder ay namatay during the term of the policy, then a claim can be made for the sum assured to be paid out. Now, The only circumstances where a claim can be declined would be the following. Death due to suicide, but after 2 years, payable na din. While death due to direct involvement in a criminal activity. And death due to an existing condition, not disclosed during the application process. On the other hand, critical illness cover is not quite as broad as life cover and would only pay out once the insured is diagnosed with a specific illness outlined within the policy. Critical illness coverage may seem to have reduced the chances of claims since it's only pay out when the insured is diagnosed as opposed to a life coverage. This is still one of the main worries being diagnosed and dealing with a critical illness like heart attack, stroke, and cancer. Kaya mahalaga na naiintindihan at napapaliwanag ng mabuti ng financial advisor ang insurance policy dahil hindi lahat ng insurer ay cover every category or occurrence of all these illnesses. Kaya it's important to review all the policy terms and conditions. And please take note, don't hesitate to ask your financial advisor to elaborate and compare their same products with other competing companies para mas makita ang advantage at disadvantages ng policies na ino-offer nila before you proceed to the next step. Number 3, who received the money in the event of a claim? Well, in the event of your death, the proceeds from a life insurance policy are paid to a beneficiary or beneficiaries who have been controlled over how many money will be spent. The policyholder can allocate a specific percentage across a number of beneficiaries. As a critical illness cover would pay out while the insured is still alive, they have full control over how the funds are used in order to aid their recovery. Number 4. When this cover is most needed. Kung kayo po ay single parent or married with dependents, you need to have a life and critical illness insurance immediately to secure and protect your family. And you need to start early while you are still young. Dahil mas magiging cheaper, smart decision at value for money kung sisimulan ng mas maaga ang security and protection. We want to make sure that our children and family's lifestyle will not be too financially affected in case of our death or once we get hit by a critical illness. But if you're single with no dependents, beyond making sure that you have adequate cover for funeral expenses. Life cover is not as much as necessity versus critical illness cover. Although, we want to make sure that you can also afford the treatments and the cost of recovery in case you are diagnosed with critical illness. So better to consider in adding this product in your insurance portfolio. In my opinion, mas importante na makapag-establish muna kayo ng emergency funds at isunod na din ang insurance plan. But I'm sure ang challenge sa inyo ay paano kayo makapag-save for your emergency funds and insurance plan. And at the same time, not too cramp in your living budget. The good thing about here, meron po akong video about why do we need to learn about the budgeting rule. Ilalagay ko po ang link sa description below para mas maintindihan ang budgeting rule presentation. Number 5. Can I combine both life insurance and critical illness cover? The answer is yes. It is possible and the good thing here, allow me to introduce AXA Health Max. It is a comprehensive health coverage against 56 major and 18 minor critical illness conditions, which provides lifetime health coverage that lasts until the age of 100, while the advanced health fund at the age of 70, which you can plan according to your budget. Just as discussed, a coverage like AXA Health Max gives you a coverage against critical illness and also serve as a life insurance coverage. In fact, ito po ang isang product na meron po kami ni Mrs. from AXA. So I personally recommend to have a trusted financial advisor to help you analyze your financial needs so that adequate coverage will be given to both of your life coverage and critical illness. Kaya thank you very much to my financial advisor, Ms. Jessie Garcia, for guiding me to all of this information. Before we end this topic, life insurance and critical illness insurance is protection to our family. It gives a health-ready financial plan, income protection for your beneficiaries, and most of all, peace of mind is achieved because of the financial security. Sana po tulungan niyo ako na makaabot ng 1,000 subscriber para mas marami pa pong matuto at magkaroon ng tamang paraan to prepare for our future. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe, and spread the word of information. Bye!